सो हाई एवरी वन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पी आई बी 247। मैं हूँ मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन गाइज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द पी आई बी न्यूज विच आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द ई एस आई सेक्शन ऑफ आर बी आई ग्रेट बी एंड नबार्ड। एंड आई होप गाइज यू ऑल हैव लाइक द जून समरी सेशन एंड आपको उससे बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइज, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन। यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस and also the updated information regarding the daily sessions and also regarding the courses. So now let's talk about the very first question, which is about the project Seabird. The question is, which of the following is correct with regard to the project Seabird? Now what is this project Seabird and why it is in news? So let's talk about this. So it is in news because Union Minister of Defense Mr. Rajnath Singh, his Lok Sabha constituency is Lucknow, which is of course in Uttar Pradesh. He visited the Karwar Naval Base in Karnataka to review the progress of ongoing infrastructure development under the project Seabird. So basically ek project Seabird chal raha hai kahan pe, Karwar mein, aur Karwar kahan pe, Karnataka mein. So basically under this project they are building a naval base, okay, ek naya naval base, they are building a new naval base at a place which is known as Karwar, which is in Karnataka, okay, and it is the largest naval infrastructure project for India. And as I told you that the project aims for creation of a naval base at the Karwar on the western coast of India, and it will be also the largest naval base east of the Suez Canal. Okay, and remember it is a $3 billion decade long project. और ये आज का project नहीं है, बहुत time से चल रहा है, $3 billion इसमें खर्चा होगा क्योंकि of course they are building a whole naval base there. Okay, कोई छोटा मोटा infrastructure नहीं बन रहा है, they are building a whole naval base. Okay, so it is a $3 billion and a decade long project. So project Seabird, I hope it is clear. And now we have to identify which of the following is correct with regards to the project Seabird. So it is the largest naval infrastructure project under which a naval base is being constructed at the Karwar on the western coast of Karnataka. All right, so option A here is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. Consider the following statements with regard to LIDAR based survey of forest areas. So Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has conducted a LIDAR based survey of forest areas. LIDAR stands for light detection and ranging. All right, in this the laser lights are used. Light detection and ranging is the full form, and in this method the laser lights are used, okay. So you have to consider the following statements and identify which are incorrect. All right, and remember the Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is Mr. Prakash Javadekar. Prakash Javadekar is the minister. Now let's talk about this. So as the question says that the Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change has conducted a LIDAR based survey of the forest in 10 states. कहाँ पे क्या किया गया? ये 10 states में किया गया. And this has been done for water and fodder augmentation. ताकि उन एरियाज में वाटर और जो फॉर्डर की ऑगमेंटेशन है वो की जा सके. एंड दीज 10 स्टेट्स गाइस वर असम, बिहार, छत्तीसगढ़, गोवा, झारखंड, मध्य प्रदेश, महाराष्ट्र, मणिपुर, नागालैंड एंड त्रिपुरा. दीज आर द 10 स्टेट्स वेयर दिस लीडार बेस्ड सर्वे ऑफ फॉरेस्ट वॉज डन. एंड रिमेंबर दिस प्रोजेक्ट विल हेल्प इन ऑगमेंटिंग वाटर एंड फॉर्डर इन फॉरेस्ट एरियाज एंड एनरिचिंग द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ रीजनरेशन ऑफ फॉरेस्ट. ओके, सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द प्रोजेक्ट. So remember, it is a first of its kind project and a unique experiment in which LIDAR technology is being used. The project was awarded to WEPCOS. Matlab, the project is being conducted by WEPCOS. And WEPCOS, guys, remember, it is a PSU under the Ministry of Jal Shakti. Ministry of Jal Shakti ke under ek PSU hai. And the funding for this project, is project ke liye funding kahan se aa rahi hai? The funding for this project is given through the CAMPA funds. CAMPA stands for Compensatory Afforestation Fund Management and Planning Authority. Okay? And what about the benefits? क्या क्या benefits होंगे? So it will reduce the human animal conflict and it will also help in identifying areas which needs the ground water recharge. It will help in catching rain water and prevent the stream runoff, and again it will help in recharging of ground water. It will guys also help in recommending different types of soil and water conservation structures which are required as per the local conditions. Okay. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. The statement number 1 is LIDAR stands for light detection and ranging. This is absolutely correct. The project was awarded to WEPCOS. Correct. The project will help in augmenting water and fodder in forest areas. So all the statements are absolutely correct, which means option D should be the correct answer. All are correct. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. where has Japanese style Zen Garden and Kaizen Academy been inaugurated? Now guys, remember this question is not so much important for the ESI point of view, but remember, looking at the changing pattern of exam, they can ask any question. So it is in current affairs. चलो अगर ESI में नहीं होगा तो तुम्हारे phase 1 में तो जरूर काम आ जाएगा. Okay, so where has Japanese style Zen Garden and Kaizen Academy been inaugurated? कहाँ पे inaugurate किया गया था? So it was in news because Prime Minister himself inaugurated these two things virtually. And these are Zen Garden and Kaizen Academy. And where these are, you know, these have been inaugurated? Ahmedabad Management Association, which is of course in Gujarat. Okay, कहाँ पे inaugurate किया गया था इनको? Ahmedabad Management Association में. These two initiatives are part of Prime Minister's vision of creating a mini Japan in Gujarat. Prime Minister has a vision to create a mini Japan in Gujarat, and under these two initiatives are the part of that vision only. Okay. And remember, these two things, the garden and the academy, are built in partnership with the Japan Information and Study Center at Ahmedabad Management Association, Indo-Japan Friendship Association, and it is supported by Hyogo International Association, which is a company of Japan. Okay. Now, what is this Zen Garden? Ye Zen Garden hai kya basically? So it will showcase several elements of Japanese art, culture, landscape, and architecture, and it is also has also a statue of Lord Buddha. And remember, Zen in Japanese is similar to Dhyan in India. जैसे हमारे यहाँ ध्यान होता है वैसे ही Japanese में क्या होता है? Zen. Now talking about the Kaizen Academy, what is this academy? So Kaizen stands for change for the better, or you can say the continuous improvement. Kaizen, guys, remember, it is basically a business philosophy of Japan. It is a business philosophy of Japan that is focused on gradually improving the productivity of the companies, of the business houses, by involving all the employees and also by making the work environment more efficient. जो हमारा work environment है उसको ज़्यादा efficient बना के और employees की involvement के साथ productivity को enhance करना, इसी को ये एक basically philosophy है, जिस philosophy का नाम होता है Kaizen. It is in India, it is being used in many departments, institutions and schemes of the central government currently. Abhi ye India mein bhi kai jagahon pe use ho raha hai. Alright. So this was about this news, and remember, Zen Garden and Kaizen Academy has been inaugurated in Gujarat, Ahmedabad Management Association. Option A will be the correct answer. Gujarat Chief Minister, remember, is Mr. Vijay Rupani. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. Which of the following is correct about the NTPC's energy compact goals? So NTPC has declared their energy compact goals. Remember, NTPC is a Maharatna. It is a Maharatna since the year 2010, and it was established in the year 1975. And of course, it is an electricity generation company. And Mr. Gurdeep Singh is the current MD and CEO. You can say the CMD of NTPC. Okay. So which of the following is correct about the NTPC's energy compact goals towards sustainability declared as the part of United Nations High Level Dialogue on Energy? So this United Nations High Level Dialogue on Energy will be held in the month of September this year. September 2021 में ये होगा. So उसके reference में NTPC ने अपने energy compact goals towards sustainability को declare किया है. Now let's talk about this. So as the question says, the NTPC Limited has become the first energy company in the India to declare its energy compact goals as part of the United Nations High Level Energy Dialogue that will be held in the month of September 2021. And it will be held in the month of September 2021 to promote the implementation of the energy related goals. जो energy related goals हैं countries के और companies के, उनको implement करने के लिए, promote करने के लिए this will be organized. And also to implement and also to promote the implementation of targets of the 2030 agenda for sustainable development. जो भी sustainable development के energy से related targets हैं, उनको implement किया जा सके जल्द से जल्द, उसको promote किया जाएगा during this high level dialogue which will be held in the month of September 2021. All right. Now what are the goals that has been declared by NTPC? So it has set a target to install 60 gigawatt of renewable energy by the year 2032. 2032 तक 60 gigawatt renewable energy produce करेंगे, install करेंगे NTPC वाले. इसके अलावा they will reduce their net energy intensity by 10%. There will be 10% reduction in the net energy intensity by the year 2032. Now what is the meaning of energy intensity? So remember, energy intensity means the energy which is used for generating a certain output. तो किसी भी काम में जो energy का use होता है, उसी को हम क्या बोलते हैं? Energy intensity बोलते हैं. and this will be reduced by 10% by 10% by NTPC जो उनका टारगेट है उसके अकॉर्डिंग. इसके अलावा दे ऑल्सो हैज दे हैव डिक्लेयर्ड दैट इट विल फॉर्म एटलीस्ट टू इंटरनेशनल अलायंसेज और ग्रुप, कम से कम दो इंटरनेशनल अलायंसेज और ग्रुप्स ये बनाएंगे टू फैसिलिटेट क्लीन एनर्जी रिसर्च एंड प्रमोट सस्टेनेबिलिटी इन द एनर्जी वैल्यू चेन बाय द ईयर 2025. ओके, सो दीज आर द गोल्स दैट हैव बीन सेट बाय एनटीपीसी. एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द क्वेश्चन, इंस्टॉलिंग ऑफ 80 गीगावाट ऑफ रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी कैपेसिटी बाय 2032. नो, इज दैट 80 गीगावाट? नो, इट्स 60 गीगावाट. 20% रिडक्शन इन नेट एनर्जी इंटेंसिटी बाय 2032. नो, दैट्स 10%. सो विच मीन्स दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ऑल्सो इनकरेक्ट. सो बोथ आर इनकरेक्ट, शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑप्शन डी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर हियर. एंड नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 सेज, इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ नैट्रेक्स हाई स्पीड ट्रैक, कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स. सो यू हैव टू कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग नैट्रेक्स हाई स्पीड ट्रैक, जो कि कहाँ पे बनाया? अभी इंदौर में. इंदौर में भी कहाँ पे? पीथमपुर. पीथमपुर एक जगह है इंदौर के पास मध्य प्रदेश में, वहाँ पे नैट्रेक्स हाई स्पीड ट्रैक इनॉग्रेट किया गया है. सो द न्यूज इज दैट द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेवी इंडस्ट्रीज एंड पब्लिक एंटरप्राइजेस. नाउ कैन यू टेल मी हु इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेवी इंडस्ट्रीज एंड पब्लिक एंटरप्राइजेस? राइट डाउन इन द कॉमेंट्स. सो दिस मिनिस्ट्री हैज इनॉग्रेटेड नैट्रेक्स हाई स्पीड टेस्ट ट्रैक इन पीथमपुर विच इज इन मध्य प्रदेश. इट इज डेवलप्ड अंडर नैट्रिप विच इज अ फ्लैगशिप प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेवी इंडस्ट्रीज. नाउ देर इज अ फुल फॉर्म ऑफ नैट्रिप ऑल्सो, नेशनल ऑटोमोटिव टेस्टिंग एंड रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट, दिस इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ नैट्रिप. डू रिमेंबर द फुल फॉर्म, दैट्स इंपॉर्टेंट. ऑलराइट, एंड रिमेंबर दिस ट्रैक इज द लॉन्गेस्ट इन द एशिया. नाउ व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ दिस ट्रैक, किस लिए बनाया गया ये? सो रिमेंबर, इट इज बेसिकली अ वन स्टॉप सोल्यूशन फॉर ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ हाई स्पीड परफॉर्मेंस टेस्ट. जो टू व्हीलर्स होते हैं या फिर जो हैवी ट्रैक्टर्स होते हैं, गाड़ियां होती हैं, उनका हाई स्पीड परफॉर्मेंस टेस्ट करने के लिए दिस ट्रैक हैज बीन इनॉग्रेटेड. ऑलराइट, एंड रिमेंबर दिस ट्रैक फैसिलिटी मेजर्स 11.3 किलोमीटर इन लेंथ विद 4 लेन्स, 4 लेन्स है इसमें, और जो इसकी लेंथ है वो कितनी? 11.3 किलोमीटर. द ट्रैक हैज बीन डिजाइन टू अचीव अ मैक्सिमम स्पीड ऑफ 375 किलोमीटर पर आवर ऑन द कर्व्स. कर्व्स के ऊपर भी 375 किलोमीटर पर आवर की स्पीड. And it is one of the safest tracks globally due to less banking on the ovals. And I hope आप सबको पता है banking का मतलब क्या होता है. Where there is a sharp turn, जहाँ पे भी sharp turn होता है वहाँ पे जो road होती है इस side से, let us say कि अगर यहाँ से ऐसे जाना है तो ये वाली जो road होगी थोड़ी सी ऊपर की तरफ inclined होगी, ठीक है, ताकि जो vehicle है वो slip ना हो सके. इसको बोलते हैं banking of roads. Okay, और ये बहुत important concept है physics का, और अगर आप physics के student रहे हो तो definitely आपको ये पता होगा. And it is located only 50 km away from the Indore. Alright. So, and talking about Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh, Shivraj Singh Chauhan is the Chief Minister. And Ms. Anandi Ben Patel is the Governor. In Madhya Pradesh, guys, remember, you will find Bandhavgarh National Park. You will find Sanjay National Park. You will find Panna and Pench National Park as well. You will find Satpura National Park also, and there is a very famous festival of Khajuraho. Khajuraho festival वहाँ पे celebrate किया जाता है, and also they also have a very famous festival which is known as Lokrang festival. Okay, so now let's come back to the question. With respect to Natrex high speed tracks, you have to identify the correct statement. So it has been developed by Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. No, अब यहाँ पे confusion हो सकती है between these two ministries. So remember, it has been developed by Ministries of Heavy Industries. Okay. It will facilitate automotive and component testing for automobile companies. This is absolutely correct. It is located in Pithampur in Maharashtra. No, it is located in Pithampur, but that is not in Maharashtra. That is in Madhya Pradesh. All right. So this track facility measures 11.3 kilometer in length. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And it has 4 lanes as well. So second and fourth statements are absolutely correct. Option A will be the correct answer. Okay. So guys, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.